space elevator technology becoming a reality, leaving the planet by space elevator. A new wave of theoretical studies comes out just when you think that scientists and engineers have given up on the idea. Some people might say that the space elevator is a great idea that can't be put away. If we spent the money to build this huge structure once, we could have had space-based solar power, habitats in space, cities on the moon and Mars and more. History. Konstantin Tsiolkovsky, 1857 to 1935, is credited with coming up with the rocket equation and the basic design of most modern rockets. He also came up with ideas for rockets with steering booster rockets, multi-stage boosters and rotating pinwheel space stations. This was inspired by his trip to Paris in 1895 when he saw the Eiffel Tower for the first time and saw how it was compressed. In 1966, four American engineers came up with the same idea for a suspension structure. A megastructure was supposed to be built with a base or anchor connected to a moving platform at sea or a fixed one on land. In the future, these cars would be able to get their power from solar panels, nuclear reactors and wireless or direct energy exchange. They can be hard to work with tethers. An idea for a thought experiment that may help humans comprehend the cosmos or an alternative means of transportation was put out by Arthur C. Clarke in 1979. The tether was unknown until quite recently. As long as Earth's gravitational pull and movement continued, the tensile strength to weight ratio was never high enough to guarantee structural integrity. 1 millimeter at the Earth's surface and up to 31,068 miles, which is roughly 50,000 kilometers above the GSO, is what Artsu Tanov said the first cable would be made out of. The weight of the tethered structure would be about 601,012 tons. This was based on very conservative estimates of the tensile strength that was needed, which he said was about 62.5 gigapascals. When it comes to things that we already know about, how close are we to making this happen? It's not at all. This is how long the best steel wire could last, about 31 miles, or 50 kilometers or so. It's important for us to make something that can be both strong and light, so we don't want to use any metal. If this is the case, we should look at new synthetic and composite materials to see if they can help us. It can last for 124 miles, which is 200 kilometers, before it breaks. Kevlar, for example, can last that long. The cables would have to be made from synthetic materials that had only been made in small amounts before. They also looked at quartz, graphite, beryllium, and diamond, but none of them were strong enough for the job. NASA Advanced Concepts Office, ACO. They were reintroduced in the 1990s. On spotting these resources, ACO member David Smitherman imagined building a space elevator. It was announced at the Marshall Space Flight Center in June 1999. Space elevators, an advanced Earth space infrastructure for the new millennium, appeared in 2000. Smitherman preferred graphite epoxy composites, preferable or mass-produced carbon nanotubes. If made of today's strongest composite materials, the space elevator's diameter would be 1.24 miles, which is 2 kilometers at GEO, and 1 millimeter at the surface. 601,012 tons tethered structure. The GEO is 0.26 mm surface, 0.15 mm. The tether would weigh 9.2 tons, half its current weight. He estimated the needed tensile strength at roughly 62.5 GPa. The strength of carbon nanotubes may be much higher, he said correctly. NASA Institute for Advanced Concepts. Carbon nanotubes may be the strongest substances ever known. This strength paired with their low density makes them vital for space elevator design. Bradley C. Edwards conducted a feasibility study for the NASA Institute for Advanced Concepts, NIAC, in 2000. The NIAC report was titled The Space Elevator. NIAC Phase 2 Final Report. Edwards' NIAC Phase 2 Final Report was published in 2003, and he continued his belief that a space elevator could be created using carbon nanotube technology. Carbon nanotubes are grown, not machine-made, and are short. The current record for single-tube growth is 20 inches, which is 50 centimeters, and for forests of them is 5.5 inches, which is 14 centimeters. New materials. Graphene was investigated as a tether material for a space elevator. Graphene sheets have a tensile strength of roughly 130 GPa or 236 times that of steel. In 2009, Alfonso Reina and his MIT colleagues revealed how graphene could be created using chemical vapor deposition, CVD. The International Space Elevator Company, ICEC, has proposed a family of 6 elevators in pairs in 3 places across the world to achieve interplanetary travel by the second part of the century. It's also 74 times cheaper than utilizing traditional rockets and launch systems between 1970 and 2000. A space elevator would provide for unlimited commercial, scientific, and tourism options, they say. For example, move 170,000 MTs of cargo to GEO and beyond. Enable GEO, Lagrange points, and beyond space stations. Allow for regular, safe, and robust transit to orbit, 7.76 kilometers per second. Allow a quick passage to Mars, 61 to 400 days. Allow daily Mars expeditions, not just every 26 months. No rocket exhaust or global warming. Not add more space garbage. The Galactic Harbor could put cargo in orbit that would ordinarily need dozens or hundreds of rocket launches only by using energy. Dr. Swan, Nixon, and co-workers estimate the cost of building such a megastructure at $18 billion, less than NASA spends yearly on space exploration. Production might start before the end of the decade, according to their estimates. Dr. Nixon, if we reduce the manufacturing cost estimate to 1 penny per square meter, the tether comes in at $3.6 billion. We still have a long way to go, but experts see the necessity for space elevators and transportation infrastructure. According to Dr. Swan, one factor is that material costs are reducing and technology is moving towards practical manufacturing procedures. External demand from SC pushes tether manufacturing technologies. We, the SC people, are excited about what is happening and the material being available for us by 2037. Inclusion of graphene in commercial products is now a major hurdle, according to Drs. Swan, Nixon, and Nelson. They fall into 3 groups. First, producers must acquire the ability to produce graphene sheets kilometers long. Second, output must be increased to several meters per minute or even per second. Third, quality control requires producing single crystal graphene sheets rather than polycrystalline. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to us.